Are you thinking about buying a flight simulator? Well, if you are, in this video, you will discover what are the different types of flight simulators out on the market and how to know which one is right for you. Now, I'm not sure whether or not you've looked into the different types of flight simulators out on the market, but if you have, you're probably aware that there's a whole range of them. On one end, you have the more generic type of flight simulator, so things such as Microsoft's Flight Simulator series or Flight Pro Sim. Then there's the more specialized flight sims for combat, and then there's also helicopter sims and even RC flight simulators. So which one do you choose? Well, it all depends on the purpose you're buying the flight sim for in the first place. But I'm not sure whether you're like me or not, but when I was growing up, I always wanted to become a pilot. And being a pilot was my childhood dream. You know, when I was at school, if somebody asked me, you know, the typical question, what do you want to do when you're older? I would reply, a pilot. The hardest decision I had was whether I wanted to become a helicopter pilot or an airline pilot. So for me, a typical or generic type of flight simulator such as Microsoft's Flight Sim or Flight Sim Pro would be suitable. This is because it has a range of small planes, large planes, and even unusual planes like the Wright Brothers plane, and also helicopters too. Plus, it also has tutorials that teach you how to fly, and this means no more having to fork out big dollars to learn how to fly. Now, if you want a flight simulator where you can battle other opponents in the sky, then you might be more suited to a combat flight simulator. The big question you might want to ask yourself is what type of plane or planes do you wish to fly? You know, do you want to see yourself in the older Spitfire, or do you want something more modern like an F-16? The answer to this question will help you work out what simulator might be best. Microsoft's Combat Flight Simulator caters typically for World War II types of planes, where older simulators such as Falcon 4.0 is specifically for an F-16. Now, while both of these sims are great fun, they both cater to totally different markets. And in the area of helicopter sims, the most typical flight simulators, like I mentioned before, I guess allow you to fly helicopters too, and all that I've played do a great job. But there's some games out there like Search and Rescue, where you take control of a Coast Guard-style helicopter, and as the name suggests, you search and rescue people. Now, for what this sim lacks in realism, it actually makes up in fun. Now, lastly, you have RC flight simulators. These ones are kind of like the generic flight sims where you get the choice of planes and helicopters. If you're thinking about buying an RC plane or helicopter, buying one of these sims will help you save megabucks and a whole lot of frustration because you hopefully won't crash as much. So look, at the end of the day, there are a variety of simulators to choose from. Which one you choose basically comes down to what you want to get out of it.